Good morning, dear students. In the last year, we have studied the concept of relations and functions. This year also, we are going to study the same concept. First, we will recall what we have learnt in the last year. In the last year, we have learnt, firstly, Cartesian product of two given sets. Suppose there are two given non-empty sets A and B. The set of all ordered pairs of the elements in A and B is called the Cartesian product A cross B. Cartesian product A cross B is the set of all ordered pairs of the elements in A and B. For example, A is equal to 1, 2, B equals 2, 6. Now, A cross B equals first element we will consider from the set A. For A cross B, we consider the first element from the set A and the second element from the set B. We will write the ordered pair as 1, 2, 1, 6, 2, 2, 2, 6. This is the Cartesian product A cross B. Then we have studied the relations. A relation R from a non-empty set A to non-empty set B is the subset of A cross B. That will be the subset of A cross B. For example, relation R, it is a set of ordered pairs. It is a subset of this A cross B, means it is a set, it is also a set of ordered pairs. This relation is derived from A cross B by describing a relationship between the first element and the second element. Therefore, relation is a set of ordered pair A comma B such that A is related to B by something. So, I will give an example R1. Suppose the set of A cross B such that A is less than B. As in set theory, we can write the sets A by set builder method or roster method. Here also, we can write the relation by set builder method or roster method. This is set builder method. Now, if I write by roster method, I am going to write the ordered pairs which satisfies this relation. Now, observe the ordered pairs in A cross B. Find out which ordered pairs satisfies this relation. It means the first element should be less than the second element. That means 1 comma 2 satisfies this relation. 1 comma 6 satisfies this relation. 2 comma 6 satisfies this relation. Now, the R1 is the relation written by roster method. We can also represent the relation by arrow diagram method also. I will show you that also. So, we will write two circles like this. So, this is A and this is B. Relation R1, this relation is R1 from A to B. I will write the elements of the set A here and elements of the set B here. Observe, one is related to 2, one is related to 2, one is related to 6, one is related to 6, 2 is related to 6. So this is the arrow diagram representation of a relation. Relation is a subset of the Cartesian product A cross B. This can be derived by the A cross B by describing a relationship between the first element and the second element. Here, the second element will be called as image of the first element. Then, we defined the domain. We defined the domain. Domain is defined as the set of all first elements of the ordered pairs of the relation from a given non-empty set A to non-empty set B. So now in this example, the domain is the first elements 1, 2. Domain is the set of all first elements of the ordered pairs of the relation from a non-empty set A to non-empty set B. Then range, we define the range. Range is the set of all second elements of the ordered pairs of the relation from a non-empty set A to non-empty set B. Therefore, here second elements means 2, 6. And we defined codomain. Codomain is the whole set B. The whole set B is called as codomain. These are all we defined in the first year PUC. And range will be the subset of R equal to, subset R equal to the codomain. Range will be subset of codomain R, it is equal to codomain. These are all we discussed in the last year in related to relations. I will repeat. Cartesian product is the set of all ordered pairs of the elements in A and B. Cartesian product A cross B. Cartesian product A cross B antandre A element in the B element ge ordered pairs alla barutta hogtivi. Aa ondu set navu Cartesian product ante heltivi. Relation from a non-empty set A to non-empty set B is the subset of Cartesian product A cross B. A cross B Cartesian product na subset agirutte one relation. In this representation of the relations, we are having three ways. One is set builder method, roster method, and arrow diagram method. Here we are going to describe the relationship between the first element and the second element. For example, A is less than B is a relation. Similarly, we can write A is equal to B, A greater than B, or any relation. We got the ordered pair satisfying this relation as 1 comma 2, because 1 is less than 2, 1 is less than 6, 2 is less than 6. And here we have written the arrow diagram and we define the domain. Domain means the set of first elements. Modale elements yavdu irutte aa element na set na venu telthivi domain ante helthivi. Aa eradne elements en irutte aa elements na set na navu range ante helthave. Inna codomain antandre whole set B na navu codomain ante helthivi. Idu relation ge samarpita. Now functions na define madtivi. Amele we define the functions. Function is a special kind of relation. It is also a relation, but it is a special kind of relation. For making you understand the functions, just I will take the help of arrow diagram. Okay. I am going to define the relation from two sets, non-empty sets A and B. So non-empty sets A, B, A, B. So 1, 2, 3, this is the relation R, okay, 2, 3, 4, A, B, C, D. So 1 is mapping with A, 2 is mapping with B, and 3 is mapping with say C. 1, 2, 3, 4. A, B, C, D. 1 is mapping with A. 2 is mapping with C. 3 is mapping with B. And 4 is mapping with say D. And here 1, 2, 3, 4. A, B, C, D. 1 is mapping with A, 1 is mapping with B, 1 is mapping with C, 2 is with D, and say 3 is with D, and 4 is with C. And 1, 2, 3, 4, A, B, C, D. 1 is mapping with A, 2 is mapping with A, 3 is mapping with A, 4 is mapping with D. So this is R1, say R2, this is R3, and this is R4. Now, among these arrow diagrams, which relation is function? Let us find. It is very clear, R1 is not a function, because a function is a relation in which every element of the set A should have one and only one image in B. That is the definition of the function. When you observe here, every element of the set A is not having the image in set B, because 4 is not having the image in B. Therefore, this is not a function. ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೇನು? ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಏನಿಲ್ಲಂತ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಗೆ ಏನಾಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು? ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅದನ್ನ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಇದು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ಈ ಕೇಸಿಗೆ ಬರೋಣ, ಆರ್ ಟು ಬರೋಣ. ಈಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ಎ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್? ನೋ, ಆರ್ ಟು ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈವನ್ ದೋ ಎವ್ರಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿ, the element 1 is having 3 images. I told you a function is a relation in which every element should have one and only one image, one and only one image. Since 1 is having more than one images, 1 is having more than one images, this is not a function. When you come to the case of R3, R3 is definitely a function. Definitely a function, because every element is having the image in B. Every element is having the image in B. And also, every element is having one and only one image. One and only one image. Every element is having one and only one image. The one is having the image A, two is having the image C, three is having the image B, and four is having the image D. Therefore, this is a function. When you come to the case of the relation R4, when you come to the case of relation R4, every element is having the image. Every element is having the image in B, and also every element is having unique image or one and only one image. See, 1 is having the image A, 2 is having the image A, 3 is having the image A, 4 is having the image B. Even though three elements are having the same image, but referring to the individual elements, the elements are having the unique image, one and only one image. That is the difference. So therefore, this is a function. A relation F from a non-empty set A to non-empty set B is called a function if every element of this first set A is having one and only one image in the second set B. Function antandre pratiyondu element unique image anna erane set alli hondidre adanna naavu function ant heltivi, illandre adu function agodilla. Idu baala mukhyavadanta vishaya na tilkolbekaddu, first year PC alli kalthiruvantadu. Innu idanna naavu roster method alli baradre hege adanna define maadthivi? ರೋಸ್ಟರ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಬರೀತಿದೆ. I am going to write by a roster method. Okay. So that is R2, R1, that is 1 is mapping with A, 2 is mapping with B, and 3 is mapping with C. And R2, R2, 1 is mapping with A, 1 is mapping with B, 1 is mapping with C, 2 is mapping with D, 3 is mapping with D, and 4 is mapping with C. When you come to the R3, 1 is mapping with A, 2 with C, and 3 with B, and 4 with D. And we come to the R4, R4, 1 is mapping with A, 2 is mapping with A, 3 is mapping with A, 4 is mapping with B. When we observe the relations written in roster method, R1 is not a function. It is very clear we are not having the element 4 in the ordered pairs. We are not having the ordered pair which is having the element 4. Therefore, this is not a function. Andre, ee modalne place nalli, ee modalne set na ella elements irbeku. Andre artha eno? Domain whole set A agirbeku. The domain should be whole set A. When you come to the relation R2, this is not a function. This is not a function because the first element is repeated. ಈ ಥರ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟು ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಆಗಿರಬಾರ್ದು, ಅವಾಗ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲ. ನೀವು ನೋಡಿದ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಹೌದು ಅಂತ. ಮೊದಲನೇ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ಈ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಡೊಮೇನ್ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಸೆಟ್ನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸು ಇರಬೇಕು. ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅದು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ನೋಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದು ಆರ್ ತ್ರೀನಲ್ಲಿ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. 1, 2, 3, 4, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್. ಸಿ, ಎಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಇದು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್. ಆರ್ ಫೋರ್ಗೆ ಬರೋಣ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. 1, 2, 3, 4, ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್, ನೋ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ ದಿ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಅನದರ್ ವೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಎ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಫ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ from a non-empty set A to non-empty set B, which is having the domain as the whole first set A and no two ordered pairs should have the same first element. No two ordered pairs should have the same first element. ಇದು ನಾನು ಯಾಕೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಇಡೀ ನಮ್ಮ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ನ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟು ಭಾಳ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾದ. ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಗೂ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಗೂ ನಮಗೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ನು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಗೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಏನಪ್ಪ ಅಂದರೆ, ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ನು ಒಂದು ರಿಲೇಷನ್ನೇ, ಆದರೆ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್. ಎವ್ರಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸೆಟ್, ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ದಟ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್. ನೌ usually for the function f from a non-empty set A to non-empty set B is written as f from A to B. F is a function from A to B where x y belongs to f is given by f of x is equal to y. That is, suppose this is A, this is B, and x, this is y, and x is mapping with y. This is the meaning, f of x is equal to y. It is also very important. I am going to name the elements here. X belongs to the set A, y belongs to the set B. We call y as the image of image of x under f. Y is called image of x. Y is called image of x under f. Y is called image of x under f. And this x is called pre-image of y. And this x is called pre-image. This is image, this is pre-image. So x is called pre-image of y. We should know the words image and pre-image. We are using further in the class. So when f of x is equal to y, y is called the image of x under f, and x is called pre-image of y under f. Pre-image of y under f. So this is the definition of image and pre-image. And also we define the real valued function. A function f from a non-empty set A to non-empty set B is called real valued function if the range of the function is a real number or subset of the real numbers. And also we define the real function. So if the domain is a real number, if the domain is also a real number or subsets of the real number, then we call that as a real function. Then we learnt different types of functions. We learnt identity function, polynomial function, constant function, modulus function, signum function, greatest integer function, their domain, range, and their graphs. After that, we learnt the algebra of functions, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication of a function by a scalar, and multiplication of two functions, and quotient of two functions. These are all we studied in the first year PUC relations and functions chapter. This year, we are going to study relation functions once again, but continued part. We are going to study mainly types of relations and functions, composition of functions, invertible functions, and binary operations. These four concepts we are going to study this year. First, we will discuss the types of relations and functions. For understanding the types of relations, I will take an example. Suppose A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, B a set. We are going to define a relation in the set A only. No. We are going to define a relation in the set A only. What is the meaning? That relation is the subset of, that relation is subset of A cross A. That relation will be the subset of A cross A. The relation I am going to define is set of all ordered pairs A comma B, where A belongs to A, B also belongs to A, the same set. A belongs to A, B belongs to A. Illi nodi onde set mele relation na define madidre ee eradu elementu A set ge serutte anta artha madkolbeku, such that A minus B is equal to 10, such that A minus B is equal to 10. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎ ಮೈನಸ್ ಬಿ ಇಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 10 ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಏನು? ಈ ಎರಡು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ನ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿರಬೇಕು? 10 ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು. ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡೆರಡು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಪರೀಕ್ಷೆ ಮಾಡಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡೆರಡು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಕಳೀತಾ ಹೋದರೆ, ಒಂದರಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಅಥವಾ ಎರಡರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು, ಮೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಅಥವಾ ಎರಡರಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂರು, ಮೂರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾಲ್ಕು, ನಾಲ್ಕರಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂರು ಅಥವಾ ನಾಲ್ಕರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು, ನೀವು ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಳೀರಿ ಎರಡೆರಡು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ನ, ಅದರ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸು 10ಕ್ಕಿರುವಂಥದ್ದು ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಎರಡು ನಂಬರ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತಾ? ಸಾಧ್ಯನೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. We cannot get the pair of two numbers satisfying this relation, this condition. Therefore, we are having the relation as an empty set. We are not getting any ordered pair. Hence, this relation is named as empty relation. This is called as empty relation. We define this empty relation as a relation R in the set A is set to be an empty relation if no element of set A is related to any element of set B. Sorry, set A. No element of set A is related to any element of set A. A relation or from a non-empty set, relation R in a set A is said to be an empty relation if no element of set A is related to any element of set A. Now we will take another relation, say R dash. It is also a set of all ordered pairs such that modulus of A minus B is greater than equal to 0. Modulus of A minus B is greater than equal to 0. Now, when we observe the pair of numbers satisfying this condition, we are getting all ordered pairs satisfying this condition. Yavde erad number tagondu pariksha madidre ella pairs kuda ee condition satisfy martave. Andre idra difference na modulus 0 ginta jaasti athwa 0 ge equal agirbeku anta artha. Hagare ella pairs satisfy madutte antandre hagadre relation enayitu, it is equal to A cross A. That means whole Cartesian product A cross A, it is equivalent to whole Cartesian product A cross A. Therefore, this is named as universal. It is named as universal relation. Now, a relation R in a set A is said to be universal relation if each element of A is related to every element of set A. Therefore, a relation R in a set A is said to be empty relation if no element of A is related to any element B. So this is empty relation. Whereas universal relation, a relation R in a set A is, sorry, this is A, okay, is said to be universal relation if each element of A is related to every element of A. Every element of A. So this is the definition of empty relation and universal relation. These are the first two types, and these two relations are called as extreme relations. These are called as extreme relations or trivial relations. Extreme relations or trivial relations. Next, we are going to study one more type of relation, that is called as equivalence relation. Very, very important. Equivalence relation. So, for studying equivalence relation, we need three types of relations. One is reflexive relation, second one is symmetric relation, and third one is transitive relation. Now, I am going to define that. After that, I will explain by taking an example. First, I will define the reflexive relation. Okay. A relation R or in a set, in a non-empty set, non-empty set A is said to be reflexive, is said to be reflexive. If a relation R in a non-empty set A is said to be reflexive if for all A it belongs to capital A, for every A or for all A it belongs to the set A, A should be related to A. A should be related to A itself. That's the meaning. A should be related to A itself. Second one. A relation R in a non-empty set, in a non-empty set A is said to be symmetric. Symmetric if for all two elements, we will consider two elements A, B, if A comma B, that is A is related to B, if A is related to B, if A is related to B, it should imply B is related to A. It should imply B is related to A. So this is the symmetric relation. This is symmetric relation. Then a relation R in a non-empty set A is said to be transitive. Is said to be transitive if for all A, B, C, it belongs to capital A, and A is related to B, B is related to C. If A is related to B, B is related to C, it should imply A is related to, it should imply A is related to C. See, if A belongs to, for all A is related to A, it is reflexive. For all A, B, it belongs to A. If A is related to B, it should imply B is related to A. It is symmetric. Transitive means if A is related to B, B is related to C, it should imply A is related to C. Then it is transitive. Illi reflexive antantandre ond element na naavu tagoltivi, aa element ade element ge relate agidre adu reflexive. Symmetric ge naavu erdu element tagoltivi, yeno element B ge relate agidre B element A ge matte relate adre adu naavu symmetric anta helthivi. Innu A element B ge relate agirbeku mattu B indane shuru agirbeku illi relation. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಆ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬರಬೇಕು ಫಸ್ಟ್. ಅದೇ ಬಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಮತ್ತು ಸಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಗೆ ರಿಲೇಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ಈ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟು ಆ ಮೂರನೇ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟಿಗೆ ರಿಲೇಟ್ ಆದರೆ ಎ ಸಿಗೆ ರಿಲೇಟ್ ಆದರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಇದು ಮೂರು ನಾನು ಈ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಇದು ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ನು ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರ ಈಗ ನಾನು ಇದನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಎನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್. Show that relation R in the set of straight lines in a plane. In a plane, set of straight lines in a plane defined as R equals L1 comma L2 such that L1 is parallel to L2 is an equivalence relation. Is an equivalence relation. Is an equivalence relation. We have to show that the relation R in the set of straight lines in a plane defined as R equals L1 comma L2 such that L1 is parallel to L2 is an equivalence relation. Equivalence relation anta navu prove madbeku. Hagade equivalence relation anta prove madbekadre idu mooru agidre equivalence relation agutte. Adu nam hella. Equivalence relation is a relation in a set A which is reflexive, symmetric, transitive. Yavade relation idu mooru agidre adu navu equivalence relation anta helteve. Adu definition ನೀವು ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು, ಬರ್ಕೊಂಬಿಡಿ. ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ನಾನ್ ಎಂಪ್ಟಿ ಸೆಟ್ ಎ ಈ ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಿವ್, ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ನೌ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಿವ್, ದೆನ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕ್, ದೆನ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ದಟ್ ದ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆನ್ ಈಕ್ವಲೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್. First we will prove this is reflexive. For proving the relation reflexive, we will consider one element L1. It belongs to capital L. For every L1, any straight line we consider, any straight line in the set of straight lines we consider, L1 will be parallel to L2. ನೀವು ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಆ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಲೈನು ಈ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಲೈನು ಅದೇ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಏನಾಗಿರ್ತದೋ ಪ್ಯಾರಲ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ಅದೇ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಗಿರ್ತದೋ ಪ್ಯಾರಲ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಎನ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಸಾರಿ ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಒನ್. ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಒನ್. It belongs to R. Therefore R is reflexive. Nodi modalne A is related to A means here L1 is related to L1 itself. Now we will prove the second one is that is symmetric. Symmetric. For symmetry we consider two elements L1, L2. And also if L1 is related to L2, that is if A is related to B means here L1 is related to L2, it belongs to the relation. What is the meaning? L1 is related to L2 means L1 is parallel to L2, that is L1 is parallel to L2, that is the meaning. Here we are having the relation parallel, therefore L1 is parallel to L2. Suppose a line L1 is parallel to L2. L1 is parallel to L2. Suppose straight line L1 is parallel to L2. It implies L2 is parallel to L1. It is obvious. So it implies L2 is parallel to L1. Therefore L2 is related to L1. Therefore R is symmetric. See, if A is related to B, it should be, if A is related to B, it should imply B is related to A. Here also, if L1 is related to L2, it should imply L2 is related to L1. Therefore, it is implied. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಎಲ್ ಟು ಇಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂತ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಈ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಏನಾಯಿತು? ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಆಯಿತು. ಈಗ ನಾವು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಸೌ ಟು ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್, ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ವಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. For all L1, L2 and L3, it belongs to L. L1 comma L2 if L1 comma L2 belongs to R, L2 comma L3 belongs to R. L1 is related to L2 means L straight line, L1 is parallel to L2. L2 comma L3 related, L2 is related to L3 means L2 is parallel to L3. L1 L2 related agide andre artha eno, L1 L2 ge parallel agide anta. L2 L3 ge related agide antandre L2 L3 ge parallel agide anta artha. Hagadre L1 L3 ge enagirutte adu kuda no parallel agirutte andre navu enu helabodu L1 is parallel to L2, L2 is parallel to L3. It implies L2 is parallel to L3. It implies L2 is parallel to L3. Therefore, L2 comma L3 belongs to R. Therefore, R is transitive. Hence, so therefore, R is reflexive. So hence, R is an equivalence relation. R is an equivalence relation. Ilen madidru navu relation R in the set of straight lines in a plane defined as R is equal to L1 comma L2 such that L1 is parallel to L2 ಅಂತಿದೆ. ಇದು ನಾವು ಈಕ್ವಲೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಈಕ್ವಲೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಮೂರು ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು, ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಿವ್, ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು. ಮೊದಲು ನಾವು ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಿವ್ನ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ವಿ. ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಲೈನು, ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಲೈನು. ಅದೇ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತದೋ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಆರ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಿವ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟು ಎರಡು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ವಿ, ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಎಲ್ ಟು. ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಲೈನು ಎಲ್ ಒನ್, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಎಲ್ ಟುಗೆ ಪ್ಯಾರಲ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ಆ ಎಲ್ ಟು ಮತ್ತು ವಾಪಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ? ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಟು, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಟು. ಇಟ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಟು ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಒನ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಎಲ್ ಟು ಕಾಮ ಎಲ್ ಒನ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಟು ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎಲ್ ಒನ್, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಆರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಇನ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಒನ್, ಎಲ್ ಟು, ಎಲ್ ತ್ರೀ. ಹಿಯರ್ if l1 comma l2 belongs to r means l1 is related to l2, l2 is related to l3 means l1 is parallel to l2. Here l2 is parallel to l3. It implies l2 is parallel to l3, sorry, l1 is parallel to l3. L1 is parallel to l3. L1 l2 parallel agidre l2 l3 parallel agidre l1 nu l3 ge parallel agirutte. ಇದು ನಾವು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಇದು ಕರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಎಲ್ಲೋನ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು. ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಕ್ವಲೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್. ನೌ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಅನದರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಕ್ವಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಇಕ್ವಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಸಮ್ ಮೋರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಇಕ್ವಲೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್. Now, for making you understand the equivalence class, I will consider an example. In the set of integers z, in the set of integers z, R is a relation defined as set of ordered pairs a comma b such that 2 divides a minus b. 2 divides a minus b. ಒಂದು ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟೀಜರ್ಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ನಾವು ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಆ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಏನು ಹೇಳುತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಅಂದರೆ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಎ ಮೈನಸ್ ಬಿ, ಅಂದರೆ ಎ ಮತ್ತು ಬಿನ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ನ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಅಥವಾ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸು 2 ಇಂದ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಮೊದಲು ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಇಕ್ವಲೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಶೋ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಕ್ವಲೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮೊದಲನೇದು ನಾವು ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಿವ್ ತಗೊಳ್ತೀವಿ. ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಿವ್, will consider an integer, say a. Suppose if I consider integer a, I have taken here a. If I consider 6, what about the difference of 6 and 6? If I consider 4, what is the difference of 4 and 4? 8. 8 and 8. The difference is 0. Does 2 divide 0? Yes. 2 divides 0. That means 2 divides 6 minus 6, 2 divides 4 minus 4, 2 divides 8 minus 8. Similarly, 2 divides a minus a. 2 divides a minus a. Therefore, a is related to a, 8 is related to 8, 4 is related to 4 itself. For all a, for any integer a, for any integer a, 2 divides, for any integer a, 2 divides a minus a, that is equal to 0. Therefore, a is related to a. Therefore, r is reflexive. R is reflexive. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ತಗೊಳ್ತೀವಿ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಿವ್ನಲ್ಲಿ, ಆ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟು ಅದೇ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಗೆ ರಿಲೇಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ ಪರೀಕ್ಷೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಎ ಮೈನಸ್ ಬಿ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಎ ಮೈನಸ್ ಎ ಆಗಬೇಕು. ಎ ಮೈನಸ್ ಎ ಅಂತಂದರೆ 0, ಆದರೆ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ 0 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಆರ್ ಅನ್ನೋದೇನಾಯಿತು, ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಿವ್ ಆಯಿತು. ಎರಡನೇದು ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕ್. ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಇಂಟಿಜರ್ ತಗೊಳ್ತೀವಿ, a ಮತ್ತೆ b. ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಝಡ್. ಎರಡು ಇಂಟಿಜರ್ನ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ. ನೋಡಿ, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ 6 ಇದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ 3 ಇದೆ. ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಸಾರಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಒಂದು ಒಂದು ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎ ಕಾಮ ಬಿ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ಎ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ, ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಡರ್ಡ್ ಪೇರ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ಮಾಡೋಂಥ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಡರ್ಡ್ ಪೇರ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ಅಂದರೆ ಈಗ 6,2 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ 6 ಮೈನಸ್ 2. ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ಡಸ್ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ 2 ಮೈನಸ್ 6? ಡಸ್ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ 2 ಮೈನಸ್ 6? 2 ಮೈನಸ್ 6ನ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದ? ಎಸ್, 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ 2 ಮೈನಸ್ 6 ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ವೆನ್ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ 6 ಮೈನಸ್ 2, 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ 2 ಮೈನಸ್ 6, ಇಟ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ 2,6 ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್. 2,6 ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ 6 ಮೈನಸ್ 2ನ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ 2 ಮೈನಸ್ 6ನ ಕೂಡ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. 2 ಮೈನಸ್ 6ನ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ 2,6 ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 2 ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು 6 ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ. ಜನರಲ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನು ಹೆಂಗೆ ಬರಿತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಇಫ್ ಎ ಕಾಮ ಬಿ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್, ಇಫ್ ಎ ಕಾಮ ಬಿ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು, ಇಫ್ ಎ ಕಾಮ ಬಿ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್, 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಎ ಮೈನಸ್ ಬಿ, ಇಟ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್, ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಮೈನಸ್ ಬಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 2 ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ b minus a, therefore b comma a belongs to r, b comma a belongs to r, therefore r is symmetric, therefore r is symmetric. When we come to the case of transitive, we'll consider we'll consider 3 elements, say a, b, c, for all a, b and c. We consider 2 ordered pairs, a comma b belongs to r, b comma c belongs to r. What is the meaning of a comma b belongs to r? That is, a is related to b means 2 divides a minus b. What is the meaning of b is related to c? 2 divides b minus c. Listen, suppose 6 comma 10 comma 6, 6 comma 2, observer for checking the transitivity, we have to consider the two ordered pairs in such a way ಎರಡು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಪೇರ್ನ ನಾವು ಹೆಂಗೆ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಮೊದಲನೇ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಪೇರ್ನ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟು, ಎರಡನೇ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಪೇರ್ನ ಮೊದಲ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು. ಆ ರೀತಿಯೇ ತೊಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ನಾವು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಪೇರ್, ಮತ್ತು ಇವೆರಡು ಈ ರಿಲೇಷನನ್ನು ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಇನ್ನು ಟೆನ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಎಷ್ಟಪ್ಪ, ಫೋರ್, ಟೂ ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಫೋರ್, ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಟು ಫೋರ್, ಟೂ ಡಿವೈಡ್ಸ್ ಫೋರ್. ಆ ರೀತಿದು ಎರಡು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಪೇರ್ನ ನಾವು ಮೊದಲು ತೊಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಟೆನ್ ಕಾಮ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್, ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಕಾಮ ಟು ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್. ನೌ ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್? 2 divides 10 minus 6, 2 divides 6 minus 2. Otherwise, this is 4, this is also 4. Now, what about 10 minus 6 plus 6 minus 2? Does 2 divides 10 minus 6 plus 6 minus 2? Yes. 4 plus 4 means 8. 2 divides 8 also. That means 2 divides this 6 cancels, 2 divides 10 minus 2. When 2 divides 10 minus 2 means 10 comma 2 belongs to R. See, when 10 comma 6 belongs to R, 6 comma 2 belongs to R, 10 comma 2, 10 comma 2 belongs to R. Similarly, we prove this by generally 2 divides A minus B plus B minus C. 2 divides A minus B plus B minus C, B gets cancels, 2 divides A minus C, therefore A is related to C, therefore R is transitive. Since R is reflexive, symmetric and transitive, R is an equivalence relation, is an equivalence R is an equivalence relation. Now I am going to explain the concept of equivalence class. Okay. Now, if I write the relation in roster form or by roster method, what may be the ordered pairs? What may be the ordered pairs? If I write the first 0, difference of 0 and which number will be divisible by 2? Obviously, it should be even number. 2 minus 0 is divisible by 2. Similarly, if I consider 1, the difference of 1 with not even number, odd number, that is 3. 3 minus 1 is 2, divisible by 2. Similarly, if you consider 2, it should be 4. If you consider 3, it should be 5, and so on. If you consider 4, it should be 6, and so on. That means when we observe very carefully here, all even numbers are related mutually. All even numbers are related mutually. And all odd numbers are related mutually, and all even numbers are related to 0 and all odd numbers are related to 1. That means difference of even numbers with the 0 will be divisible by 2, difference of odd numbers with 1 is divisible by 2. We say all even numbers e are related to 0. All odd numbers are related to 1. We call this as E as equivalence class containing 0, O equivalence class containing 1. That means this is a set of elements related to 0. Odd numbers is the set of elements related to 1. even numbers comes under this class, all odd numbers comes under this class, and these are mutually disjoint. These two are mutually disjoint, and these are all subsets of, these are all subsets of, these are all subsets of Z. These are all subsets of Z. 2 minus 0, 4 minus 0, 6 minus 0, 8 minus 0, 10 minus 0, and so on. If you subtract 0 from even numbers, they are divisible by 2. Therefore, the set of even numbers is equivalent to the equivalence class containing 0. And 3 minus 1 is 2, 5 minus 1 is 4, 7 minus 1 is 6, and so on. They are divisible by 2. Therefore, the set of odd numbers is equal to the equivalence class containing 1. That means set of odd numbers is related to 1, set of even numbers is related to 0, and these two are mutually disjoint sets, and they are the subsets of the Z. Which is dividing this Z into these two subsets? This relation. This relation is dividing the set of integers into two disjoint subsets E and O. Here, all the elements of the set E, here, all the elements of, all the elements of E are related to each other, are related to each other, and all the elements of O are also related to each other. Andre artha eno, odd numbers na difference enagirutte. Suppose if I consider 6 and 8, 8 minus 6 is 2, divisible by 2. 10 minus 6, 4, divisible by 2. 12 minus 8, divisible by 2. That means all even numbers are related to each other. Similarly, if I consider the set of odd numbers, they are related to each other. If I consider two odd numbers, say 7 and 3, 7 minus 3 is divisible by 2. That means the elements of the odd number set is also related to each other. But no two elements of E and O are related to each other. No two elements of E and O are related to each other. That means if I consider one even number and one odd number, what is the difference? If I say I will consider 4, another one is 7. 7 minus 4, 3. It is not divisible by 2. That means no two elements of E and O are related to each other. And thirdly, union of E and O will be equal to Z. Union of even numbers and odd numbers will be equal to the set of integers, and E intersection O will be a null set. That means they are disjoint. They are disjoint. Generally, we can define the equivalence class as, if Rin is an equivalence relation in the set X, then R divides X into mutually disjoint subsets, say Ai, where I is 1, 2, 3, etc., satisfying the following conditions, that is, all the elements of Ai are related to each other. Second one is, no two elements of Ai and Aj are related to each other, where I is not equal to j, and union of A is equal to X and Ai intersection Aj is equal to null set. Equivalence class. Given an equivalence relation R in a non-empty set X, R divides X into mutually disjoint subsets such that all subsets AI such that all elements of AI are related to each other. Second one, no two elements of AI and AJ are related to each other. And thirdly, union of AI is equal to X and AI intersection AJ is equal to null set. These subsets AI are called as, these AI are called as equivalence classes. Equivalence classes. In the next class, I am going to explain with another example this equivalence class, simple example, and also we will switch over to the solution of some problems based on the relations in the next period. Thank you.